skinny, but he's got teeth on the surface, splashing and crashing. He stays under the water, because out in the water is deep and it's dark and it's murky, so you can't see what's underneath there. He doesn't blow any bubbles, he doesn't make any ripples. Out in the wild, he's invisible, but he knows where I am, because he can feel where I am from vibration and from pressure changes in the water. And nothing in his water gets him really, really angry. So he'll come right over just like this and set himself up. He wouldn't show himself like that to Bob, but then he'll strike. Good boy. Look at this to the base of his tail, so hard and fast, animals like kangaroos and wallabies can't get out of the way quick enough. That's where he's dynamite, the water's edge in that strike. So, what we'll do now, so I'll try and get him to do another strike over that side of the water, but keep in mind, as I go back over here, on the land he doesn't try and get me, but as soon as I go near the water, he's going to come in. He doesn't want me in his water. This is his home. This is where he lives. And since he doesn't want me in here, I'm going to get out. Thankfully, avoiding crocodiles is simple. Just do the exact opposite of what I'm doing. Stay out of the water and back from the edge. Now here, he can strike out and hit his fence in one go. So if I seem nervous, because I am. He's got phenomenal pressure. Missing it. Phenomenal pressure. Even if he didn't have a tooth in his head, his jaw pressure is so powerful, so far beyond any other animal, like lions, jackals, whatever. That's all rubbish. None of them come close to a crocodile. If he didn't even have a tooth in his head, and he beat me mid-body, he could crush me down to a couple of centimetres deep, I'd blow out either end like toothpaste, and gee, you would get a good shot. But it would wreck my day, so I'm not going to do it. But don't go, oh, evil monster, too strong. Very quick, powerful, effective and humane way of catching and killing your prey, all over no time. He's fairly much. There's another place to catch this food, and that's directly above the water. And I'm going to go down there now, but I've got to get past it. It always makes me worry. Water's edge, you're in a bit of strife. You're hanging there washing your smalls in the edge of the water, getting a drink, whatever. So you don't want to do that. The other thing you don't want to do is overhang the water. Now, a lot of people see these big Malaluga trees up in North Queensland, around the Billabongs, Northern Territory, and they grow almost horizontally out of the water. They look like a great place to sit there and dangle your legs down, or go fishing to see if you can catch a barra. But the flying foxes, snakes, they don't hang out in there too. And he'll be looking for them. He looks for them in the water. So he'll go off just like this. 3 points above the water, and he sees something, and he starts angling up. Boy. And he'll do that car walk. So watch again. Watch again, and this time, you want to watch his tail and his back legs. That's where he gets his power from. His tail and his back legs. So he's going to push off of those back legs and use that tail to shoot straight up and out of the water. on bone. Bang. So anything in there,
that's the end of it.
But keep that in mind, and remember, the last thing you want to do is overhandle water in crocodile territory.
So crocodile territory is not here on the Sunshine Coast. It begins up in North Queensland, continues over the top of Australia, and ends over near Broome in Western Australia. They much prefer to reside up in those warmer waters.
Righto, to the KFC for a minute. We're going to try and show you now just how fast a crocodile can run on the land. Now, some people tell you, crocodiles run as fast as a horse. I can't run that fast. I'm getting a bit old now. Definitely not going to be able to run that fast. So he does, I'm in a world of hurt. Come on, big boy. Come on. He likes that power. He wanted another one out there. Here he is. He's keen to. So let's find out. Strike from the edge, like I said, he's got one. He's real quick. So here I've got to be careful. Come on. That tile of water, it gives him power. But now, hard soil around this. That is flat out for him on hard soil ground. They're just not fast on hard soil ground. In fact, I'll put my money where my mouth is. If I can sit here, maybe he can fly out. As long as I keep an eye on him, I know I can get up out of the way because he's come forward. And he knows that too, which is why he's not chasing me. And have a look at his body and you can see why. As short as I am, my legs are longer than his, I can outrun him on land. Anyone here can. Trust me, when a crocodile chases you, you will outrun it. But, like I said, have a look at his body and you can see why. He's got short legs, wet feet, little front legs, very long body, straight out on the ground, and that big tail dragging behind him. It's like you with a tire tied behind you, so on your down. On land, he is slow. But you put all that together in the water, it's a whole different subject. As soon as I go near the water, you see him having a look. He doesn't like it. And he knows that's where he can catch me. Because that big tail in the water is laterally compressed and it's all muscle. That's what gives him his speed in the water. Those little legs, they're webbed feet, and he can fold them back, and he's got that torpedo shape. In the water, I don't care how many gold medals you won at the Olympics, you cannot outswim a crocodile. But despite how fast he is in the water, despite how strong his jaws are, and the fact that you will not see a crocodile if he doesn't want to be seen. All that aside, he's still the easiest predator in the world to avoid. All you've got to do is stay out of the water. So never, ever go swimming in crocodile territory. Doesn't matter how many locals tell you you can. Don't go swimming and stay back from the water's edge, and you'll never come into conflict with one of these big crocodiles. Now, something else, I'm going to get on my high horse here. Something else has happened recently in Queensland. They've been doing it for a while in Northern Territory. Northern Territory is a whole different kettle of fish. The Queensland crocodile population is vulnerable. They are not doing anywhere near as good as other places. And the Queensland government, in all their wisdom, has allowed croc farmers to steal crocodile eggs from the wild. Now, these are the apex predator, the most important animal in our northern ecosystem, and taking their babies out of the wild is not going to help anything. Not the cute and fairy animals, nothing. All relies on him and his population being healthy for everything else to be healthy. So have a look up on the big screen and watch what Bindi's got to say about it.
It'll eat you.